Hello there, my music lovers. I'm George from Audiophile Heaven, and today we're having a look at a DAP that it's in pursuit of perfection. This is the Ibezo DX300, the flagship DAP of 2021. The Ibezo DX300 is pretty much a mid-range smartphone, at least in technicals, but with the audio of a top-end DAP. This is pretty much combining the best of both worlds. It is going to have the best. It has a Snapdragon CPU, a mid-range one actually, not even an entry-level one. It is a high-quality mid-range one that I have used on my smartphones for years. It has 6GB of RAM, 128GB of internal memory, plus a 1 microSD slot. It has 4 DACs from Cirrus, and the DACs are actually a bit of a controversy, and I'll explain in just a bit. And it has an amazing display. This is the first DAP that I love for its display, and I'm going to be comparing it to both the Lotopo 6000 and the original DX220. So let's get on with the unboxing. The unboxing of the DX300 is actually a pretty exquisite experience. It is pretty similar to what DX220 Max had. Unboxing the DX300 is really nice. This is the DAP, and this is how it is presented in this beautiful case. The DAP looks astounding. It is a really beautiful unit. Also really big. This is pretty much in line with my smartphone in terms of size, but quite a bit thicker. So it is not exactly DAP sized anymore. It is more like smartphone sized, but kind of thick. It has 2 batteries inside, one for the digital part and one for the analog part. The one for digital is smaller, and it actually tends to drain a bit faster. I was never able to empty out the analog battery. It also charges pretty fast, and you don't need 2 chargers this time around. If you've read my full written review about the DX220 Max, the thick, the large one, you needed to charge it with 2 separate chargers. Ibezo actually corrected that, and you only need 1 charger, a Type-C charger, for the DX300, which is good actually. It is pretty practical. It has the microSD slot on the right side. It has this volume / button thingy, which you can also press to open it up, and it has play buttons. It is pretty practical actually. It has interchangeable modules at the bottom, and Ibezo will be releasing new modules, which I will hopefully be reviewing for you. This is the AMP11, or how they call it, and it has 4.4mm, 2.4mm both in balanced mode, and a 1 3.5mm output. It also has a coaxial output at the top, and the USB Type-C is at the top. Everything about it is amazing. The back of the DAP shines beautifully in 2 colors. It is a lighter blue at the top and the darker blue / gray at the bottom. It is not a one color back of a DAP, and it is pretty cool in actual practice. You can open it up by keeping the volume wheel pressed, and the volume wheel kinda clicks while turning it. The clicks are very precise. It never misses one. It never adds one. It is precise. The boot time is really low, especially if you consider that the OS, or operating system, is pretty similar to a default Android. It takes just a tiny bit to boot it up. Now it is already turned on. The screen is much better than I can ever photo or show it to you. It is beautiful. And I will make a big point out of this, but regardless of how good a DAP is, the screen is a big part of the DAP experience. It is a big part of how you feel while using it. You have the information about the file playing right beneath the cover art. You have this beautiful bluish kind of background, but you can actually change that. And you have the play buttons at the bottom. You can quickly sync on the song. And Ibezo DX300 can be used both as a Bluetooth sender and also as a Bluetooth receiver if you fancy using it as a Bluetooth DAC. I mean, you are already paying $1,200 for it, so it makes sense to have a ton of features. I would actually prefer having those features rather than not. Of course, it works as a USB DAC too, and that was a big part of how I've used it with my PC computer in the back, because I enjoyed the sound so much that I want to have it on my desk experience too, not just portable, but with me every time. It has a pretty bright display. You can notice that here. So compared to the actual brightness of my room, it is still bright, and that means that it will be fully visible and legible in full daylight. You can customize the wallpapers, and there are 3 options now, but Ibezo could add and may add more with further firmware updates. This is a pretty cool thing, but Ibezo is actually known for offering excellent support for older products, so even though it has been released right now at the beginning of 2021, it is going to still receive firmware updates for a really long time. They are still offering updates for their older players, so pretty good support from iBASO. As part of the iBASO environment, you can actually boot it up in Mongo mode or in Android mode. In Mongo mode, you pretty much don't have access to any of the typical Android features, but it is focused on playing music and the experience is really smooth and really simple actually. It is a very basic dApp in that situation and that is how I've been using it the most. I like having just music, just no distractions, just music. I have used it for Tidal too and it does an excellent job. It has good Wi-Fi support, good Wi-Fi signal, good Bluetooth signal, and Tidal plays flawlessly, but at the same time I really prefer just playing music from my microSD card. It feels more at home for me. You know, when you have a really large CD collection and rip it yourself to FLAC files, you really feel it when you play it, and this is how I feel. I really like playing my own files. I'm not such a big fan of streaming because every single streaming app has only a limited collection from an artist. None of them doesn't have the entire collection, none of them has everything from that artist, and that was a huge disappointment for me actually, because for example I'm a big fan of some very obscure bands, especially metal, black metal, some really edgy technical death metal, and yeah, you can't find that stuff on Tidal and on Kaboos and on all of the other streaming apps, so I just prefer having the files with me all the time. I make one microSD card with all my important collections and that is how I'm using dApps. This is where I've noticed that it does an excellent job, by playing your own files. Booting it between Android and Mongo mode takes very little time, it is just pretty much the typical boot time, and the play buttons are available in both modes. The volume wheel is available in both modes as well, so it is pretty much a full-fledged dApp, but with Android support, you can actually download any single app and install it, and it is pretty much a full-fledged dApp. I'm insisting on that so much because here I have the Lotto Pro 6000. It is pretty close in terms of pricing, and when you look at the two, you notice the difference. The Lotto Pro 6000 is much, much smaller. It has a much simpler UI or user interface, and it is very basic in terms of overall usage. The DX300 is complex, it has a ton of features, it is excellent in everything. The Lotto Pro 6000 just has this menu, it is so basic. The sound actually is not how would you expect, then Lotto Pro 6000, it's a very capable dApp, but when using both as a dApp, just imagine using this smartphone looking guy and playing your collection from it, and imagine having to browse to Lotto Pro 6000. The DX300 is clearly the winner in overall graphical user interface. The DX300 is also the winner when compared to the original DX220, because the original DX220 had some minor issues that I only noticed after using it for a really long while. For example, when using both as USB DACs for my computer, when pausing a song, this one would do a little pop noise and would only start playing the new song after a few fractions of a second. The DX300 doesn't seem to have this issue, and I actually noticed that the ergonomics are better for the new DX3000. Despite this one being smaller, it is a bit wider and in my hands it stands a bit uncomfortably. Both of them are a bit large for one-handed usage, and just look at this, both of them are kinda big, and the DX300 is even larger, and I have large hands. If you have really tiny hands, probably both of them are going to feel pretty big. Besides the size, you can see that the new model is built a bit better, but it is built much simpler, very few things to break. Getting YouTube to work has been a bit of an issue for me so far, and I couldn't really figure out how to get it to work, but by the time I'm writing the full written review, I will hopefully have figured that out. You can also notice that it is really quick, the UI is really quick, and that Snapdragon CPU really does its job. DX300 comes with both cool APK and APK Pure to install apps. Because it is made in China, it doesn't really have Google Play support so far. And this is pretty much everything that I found interesting about its build and its overall Android interface. Now let's get to the sound. The sound of the DX300 was amazing. It is a very simple word to describe my feelings about its sound, because it really beats the original DX220 even when using the best amp modules it has. I typically love the AMP7 the most, and the AMP9 was magical for me, but it didn't really have enough driving power to make sense. And the DX300 really outdid it. It is really better. It is so much better. It has better resolution, better detail, but at the same time it is a very natural type of sound. It doesn't really color the sound. The AMP7 feels very forward, very aggressive, but at the same time it lacks the refinement and maturity of the sound of the DX300 with its original AMP module. The sound of the DX300 can be described as the most natural DAP I've heard to date, and it is more natural than the Lotopo 6000. The Lotopo 6000 sounding pretty similar but a bit softer. It is like it's a bit softer around all edges, also a bit more splashy. Ibeso DX300 sounds more natural in that aspect. I like the splashy sound of the Lotopo 6000 quite a bit. It is not a bad sound, it is a very enjoyable type of sound. But the DX300 sounds more mature and more evolved. It sounds like it is the final evolution of a DAP. This is how a DAP should sound like. Comparing it to the big one, to the DX220 Max, the largest DAP I've reviewed to date, the DX300 actually sounds pretty good too. It doesn't really sound like a downsized version, it sounds pretty mature still. The bigger one sounds a bit softer, surprisingly to my ear it is a bit softer, also a bit warmer in the overall tuning, but it also has slightly better dynamics and a bit more punch. The DX300 seems to be the most natural out of the bunch and the most overallly balanced. It is a very balanced type of sound. I was able to drive pretty much everything that can fit in those plugs with it, and it sounds considerably better out of the balanced port. It doesn't really sound bad out of the single-ended port, but it really shines when connecting something to that balanced port. And I totally recommend you to try and to test it with the balanced port. If you have balanced cables, you will understand what I mean. You'll understand the beauty of its sound. I tested it with Ibeso IT07, and the IT07 is amazing too. But the DX300 is the big surprise, because this is like a dream DAP to me. It has a beautiful large display, which I always wanted. It has a much better battery life than the original, because the original had a pretty disappointing battery life. Most people quote between 7 and 8 hours of maximum battery life for the DX220. The DX300 can continue playing forever. It is like the battery never dies. The battery actually survives for up to 10 hours, and that was tested by me and I got bored and stopped the test. It could play a bit more, especially if you aren't as demanding as I am. I'm a very demanding user. I demand the maximum brightness. I change songs quite often and I really like to browse my collection, and I like to listen almost at maximum loudness usually. And this was another big thing. I don't really feel the need to push it to its maximum loudness, because the DX300 has a very high maximum loudness, it has a good amount of driving power, and there was no headphone that really made me push it to the maximum. You can imagine this as a compliment, because most of DAPs tend to run out of headroom before I run out of patience. energy to listen to them. But yeah, the DX300 still has headroom for me. The experience of listening to the DX300 is like listening to a high-end DAC/amp. It's like taking the MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus, but making it a DAP, but also making it more detailed and more natural. The MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus sounds wider than the DX300, but at the same time, it doesn't sound quite as refined. The DX300 is really refined. The textures are detailed, but at the same time, they have zero grain. It presents voices with detail but doesn't make them aggressive or too forward. Everything about the sound is really, really nice. And I really should mention, but it has a great package too. Usually I put this at the start of the video, but this time I really wanted to mention the case. The case it comes with is beautiful. This is how a case for a DAP should look like. It is blue in color, kinda similar to its original color, but offers very good protection from all sides except top. One thing though is that it slides out of the case quite easily. Just doing that will make it slide out, and you should be really careful if you have it in your case, because if you do like a swing, it is going to poof. It will fly right to the moon. Be careful, the case doesn't keep it there. I could actually recommend putting a bit of rubber in between the case and the DAP, and that will create enough friction for it to stay still. The package also has a bag of accessories, almost like it was delivered by Santa Claus. And inside this bag of accessories, you can find screen protectors, and I want to mention this, but my unit doesn't have a screen protector applied from the factory. I am not sure if all units will have just one included in the package and none applied, but my unit does not have a screen protector applied, and you should be careful, because if yours doesn't have one and you scratch it, you are scratching the actual display. Just apply this. And one trick I've learned also from YouTube is that you should always apply those screen protectors in your bathroom, because if the air is kind of wet, there will be very little actual dust in the air, and that is pretty cool to know. There is a USB cable for charging and for using it as a USB dock. There is a burn-in cable in the balanced format, and that will come in handy for other players too. And there is the coaxial out cable, because to use the 3.5 mm output as a coaxial connector, you will need a special cable that is included in the package. Included in the package of this video review are also my feelings, my honest impressions, and my hopes that you'll have a really lovely week in there, my hopes that this has been a really enjoyable video, my hopes that you'll subscribe to this YouTube channel, to my YouTube channel, to Audiophile Heaven, my hopes that you will leave a like on this video if you enjoyed the content, and my hopes that you will really have a lovely week in there. Hope to see you really soon. Bye bye!